Good morning students, welcome you all in the next online lecture of science. In the previous lecture we have completed chapter 3, that is diversity in living things and their classification. In this chapter we understood about the diversity in living thing, that means variety in living things which are plants and animals, and afterwards we saw why there is a need of classification of the animals and plants. Okay, so why there is a need of classification? In order to remember them and in order to understand them, we have to classify them. Then afterwards we saw different bases or criteria on which plants and animals are classified. Okay, so I hope you must have understood the chapter. Now coming Wednesday, that means day after tomorrow, we have a doubt solving session. You got the timetable, you know it, okay? And now you know how to click the link and how to enter Google Meet, so you might have become expert now. So we have completed 3 chapters, and in that first 2 chapters, whatever doubts you have, that you will share today on our WhatsApp group, correct? Today means Monday. So we are going to share on WhatsApp group, so that I can answer your queries. Please take a note that student only ask about chapter 1 and 2. Nothing else to ask. Okay. So today let us start with the question answers of chapter number 3. For previous 2 chapters I gave you the PDF. I shared the PDF on the WhatsApp group. Okay. But you know that our madam is very concerned about your health. And what she said is, when you are exposing to the screen more, it might get stress on your eyes. Okay, so she said don't share PDF. Instead, what school is going to do is, school is going to give you the printed copy. Okay, whatever answers they are not there in textbook, means which are out of the test, for those answers we are going to give you printed copy, and from that easily you can copy it in your workbook. So whenever I say that for a particular question you are going to get a printout, there you leave the space, don't write. Okay, I'm going to display the answer on the screen. If it is possible for you to write, then you write. If it is not possible, then you can write it afterwards when you are going to get the printed copy. Okay, I hope you might have understood my instructions. Okay, so today now let us sit with your workbook and your textbook, pen and pencil. So wherever possible you can do the markings in your textbook, okay, so that you will be less exposed to the screen, okay, and there will not be stress on your eyes. If possible for you, you copy down it, no problem, okay. But please note that I am not going to share PDF now, so don't ask for PDF on the group. I don't want those messages, got it? So let us start now. Question number 1 from the workbook. Fill in the blanks. Start writing immediately. First one. Plants prepare their own food. Therefore, they are called autotrophs. Write down autotrophs. AUTOTROPHS. Correct? All of you have studied this. I have taught you that why they are called as autotrophs, okay? So once again the spelling, AUTOTROPHS, okay? Completed. Let us go towards second one. Pitcher plant is insectivorous. Write down insectivorous. INSECTIVOROUS, insectivorous. Let us go further. Third one. The flower is an important means of reproduction. Reproduction is the answer. REPRODUCTION. Okay, next, fourth one. Stem of dash is fleshy. You know the answer. What is the answer? Cactus. Write down cactus. C A C T U S. Cactus. Next, climbers like money plant have dash roots. Answer is aerial roots. Aerial spelling A E R I A L. A E R I A L. Aerial roots. Next, animals have various dash which carry on various functions inside the body. Now see in your workbook, the comma is given between two fill in the blanks. Cut that comma. If the comma should not be there, that comma should appear after the complete fill up. Okay, two words are there, but in between those two words, comma cannot appear. Okay, so please cut that comma and write it afterwards. Okay, so how the answer should be? Animals have various organ systems, and then put comma. Okay, organ system is fill up. Two words are there. Okay, so write down organ systems. O R G A N. Organ, S-Y-S-T-E-M-S, systems, organ, systems. Okay, now the last one, earthworm is an dash animal. Okay, so the answer is invertebrate. Earthworm is an invertebrate animal. Spelling of invertebrate, I-N-V-E-R-T-E-B-R-A-T-E. Once again, I-N-V-E-R-T-E-B-R-A-T-E. Invertebrate. Okay, so why I am dictating the spelling? So that you should not see towards the screens. Only see wherever it is necessary. Okay, so I hope you have completed fill ups. Let us go towards question number 2. That is, write whether the following statements are true or false. Okay, first one, the snail is an aquatic animal. Answer what? False. Why? You know that snail is living on land, not living in water. So snail is not an aquatic animal. So the statement is false. Okay, write down false. Second one, amphibians can live in air and in water. Again the statement is false. What are amphibians? Those who live on land and in water. Okay, not in air. So because of that word air, if you want, you can underline that wrong word. Because of that word air, the statement is false. It should be land. Got it? Next, the function of the brain is well developed in vertebrate animals. Statement is true. It is less developed in invertebrates, but developed in vertebrates. So the statement is true. Okay, statement number 4. The amoeba is a multicellular animal. Immediately you will say that it's a false statement, because so many times we have seen that amoeba is a unicellular animal. That means animal with single cell. So write down the answer as false. Next, dodder is a heterotrophic plant. Okay, we know that generally plants are autotrophs. Why? Because they prepare their own food by themselves. But this dodder plant is not autotroph. Okay, it grows on some other plant. I have taught you that that plant is called as host, and it destroys that host. So dodder is sucking all the nutrients from the host. Therefore, dodder is a heterotrophic plant, and so that statement is true. Write down the answer true. Next, sixth one. Method of classification that was given by Carlos Linnaeus is used only in Europe. False. Statement is false, because Carlos Linnaeus was the first one who gave the criteria for the classification, and it was accepted all over the world. So the statement is false. Okay, next, the herb of fenugreek is perennial. False. You know that fenugreek means methi, which we eat. Okay, and that fenugreek plant is very small herb, and it lives maximum for 1 year. That means it is annual, so it cannot be perennial. Perennial means what? The plant which lives for many years. So here the statement is false. Okay, last one of true or false. Honeybee is an aerial insect. Statement is true. We have studied in the classification on the basis of habitat, how the animals are classified. Insects and birds, they spend most of time of their life in the air. They fly in the air. So they are called as aerial insects. And therefore the statement is true. Correct? Always keep habit of underlining the wrong word in case of false statement, so that you will understand that why the particular statement is false. Because in higher standards, when you are writing true and false, it is simply not enough to write true or false. You need to justify your answer. You need to correct your statement. Therefore, keep habit of this, that why the particular statement is false and why it is true. Especially in case of false statement, here the space is not given to write down the correct statement, but at least you can underline the wrong word so that you can place the correct word there. Okay, let us go for the question number 3. Who is the odd one out? Okay, question number 3. Who is the odd one out? Now on the screen you will see only answers, and beside that I have given you the reason that why that particular element is odd man out. Okay, you are, once again I am saying that you are not having space there to write down the reason, but if you want, you can write down in the next line where some space is given in workbook. Okay, if possible write. Writing the justification is not compulsory in lower standards, but still I am making you habitual because you have to do it in higher standards. Okay, so the first one, fungus, mushroom, chrysanthemum, spirogyra. Okay, so from this easily you will make out that chrysanthemum is a odd man out. Why? Because it is a flowering plant. Okay, and others means fungus, mushroom and spirogyra, they are non-flowering. So write down the answer. Chrysanthemum. Spelling is there, so no need of dictation. Or simply you can underline that word and afterwards you can write it. Okay. Next, mango, banyan, palm, chickpea. Okay. So here, when you are reading this, think about these plants, that how they are, and immediately you will come to know that palm is odd man out because palm tree do not have branches. Others they have branches. Okay. So write down the odd man out, palm. Third one, grape, orange, lemon, hibiscus. So finding the odd man out is very easy. Grape, orange, lemon, all they are what? Fruits. And hibiscus is what? Flower. So the odd man out is hibiscus. Okay. Next, sunflower, banyan, jawar, bajra. Okay. So see, sunflower, jawar, bajra, they are small herbs and they live only for 1 year. Opposite to that, banyan is a big tree which lives for many years. That means banyan is a perennial plant and others are not perennial. So the odd man out is banyan. Correct. Next, fifth one, guava, radish, carrot, beetroot. Okay. So here also immediately you can get the odd man out. That is, guava is odd man out because guava is fruit, while radish, carrot and beetroot, they are roots. Okay. So we can classify them or we can find out the odd man on the basis of the part of the flowers. That guava is a fruit, others are roots. Last one here, deer, fish, man, worms. Okay. So here there are two possible answers. That is why I am telling that you should write down the reason. That you might think that something else also is an odd man out. So for your answer, you should write down the reason. So keep habit of that. Now here first we can find as fish. Why? Because fish is an aquatic animal, lives in water. Opposite to that, the remaining are terrestrial animals. Okay, so the first criteria is this on their habitats, that fish is aquatic, therefore it's odd man out. And second one, we can take it out as worms. Why? Because worms, they don't have vertebral column. That means worm is invertebrate. Opposite to that, deer, fish and man, they have vertebral column, so they are vertebrates. Okay. So two possible answers. Write down both of them. Okay. And why they are there, the reason is given there. Okay. So I hope you have completed this one. Let us go further. Question number 4. Write 2 names of each. Now here I have given 2 names. It is not compulsory that you should also write the same 2 names. You can write down other names also. Okay. So here only thing is that your answer should be correct. Like first one, a flowering plant. You know that there are innumerable flowering plants. We can see many flowering plants. So you can write down any 2 examples. Here I have taken mango and hibiscus. You can write rose also. You can write periwinkle also. There are so many flowers. So write any 2 names. Second one, a non-flowering plant. So here also we have seen many examples. I have written algae, and ferns. Okay, you can write down another names also, as I have said. Next, a tree, teak and neem. Now mango also is a tree, banyan is a tree. Write down anything. Okay, and even you can see the answers in textbook. In textbook, all the examples are given in the classification. Okay, for example, this classification you will find on page number 21, 20 and 21. You can find the classification of plants there. So you can go there. Now for shrub, a shrub, oleander and lantana. See there, the top part of your textbook, shrubs is given, and in that another examples also are given of shrubs. Hibiscus is given, corante is given, rose is given. So you can write any two. Okay, then a creeper. So creepers also, you know the many examples, but generally here you can write any, means what, pumpkin, you know, cucumber is there, you know, sweet potato creeper is there. So anything you can write here also. You can see on page number 21 the examples are given. You can see that picture, watermelon is there. So all these are the examples of creepers. See there, can you tell? In that you will get many names of creepers. Next, sixth one, an annual plant, means the plant which live for only 1 year. So you know that all the grains, they are annuals. Rice, wheat, jawar, bajra, and sunflower is also an annual plant. So write any two examples. I have written rice and sunflower. You can write down others also. Okay, next, match the following. It is quite possible for you to do it. Okay, so try to do it by yourself first, and if not possible, I will show you the screen within 1 minute. So first of all, try to do amphibian. See in group B, who is amphibian there? Amphibian means what? The animal which live in on land as well as in water. So immediately find out. Vertebrate means the animal with vertebral columns. And with scales means, you know, scales means they have the body covering of scales. Okay, so here you can write down the examples. See, check your examples. Amphibian, a frog. Frog can live in both the places. Vertebrate is monkey. And animals with scale is snake. Snake is having scale on its body. Correct, na? So go for the second one also similarly. First one is tree. So see which are trees here. Mango and gulmohar. Shrubs, the plants with medium height. So here shrubs, just now we have seen the examples, oleander and lantana. Third one, herb, fenugreek means methi, and periwinkle. Periwinkle is also called as sadafuli. We call it sadafuli, correct? Fourth, creeper. So creepers are what? Pumpkin and cucumber. You will find that whatever examples are given in match the following, same examples I have written in, write two names each. Okay, so the answers are there on the same page. You can find them there only. Okay, so try to be smart. Do smart study. You will find the answers there and there only. Okay, so I hope you have completed match the columns. Let us go towards question number 6. What is the difference? For this, again you have to observe page number 20, 21, 22 and 24. Okay, for all the three answers I am telling you that you have to go on these pages 20, 21, 22 and 24. So the first one, flowering plants and non-flowering plants. There, the answer you will find on page number 20 and 21. Okay, so just see. What is the difference? First one, flowering plants and non-flowering plants. Okay, so two parts are given. So in the first part, write down flowering plants. In the second part, write down non-flowering plants. The space is given for heading. Green color lines are provided. So there you write down the headings, flowering plants. And in the second column, non-flowering plants. Okay. So the very first point is very easy because the name only suggests that flowering plants bear flowers. Non-flowering plants do not bear flowers. Okay. So there you can get the point. Write down the point. Flowering plants, they bear flowers. Non-flowering plants, they do not bear flowers. See on page number 22. Flowering plants and non-flowering plants. Top part of your textbook. Plants that bear flowers are called flowering plants. Did you get the line? So that can be your first point. Mark it. While the plants that never bear the flowers are called as non-flowering plants. You can change the framing of statement. You can write in your own words. Okay, so as I have made the statement simple. First point, flowering plants bear flowers. Non-flowering plants do not bear flowers. Okay. Then see the fourth line there. Third line, last word, and fourth line. Non-flowering plants may not have organs like roots, stem, leaves. So, there's a point only is given for non-flowering. From that, you can write for flowering. That flowering plants have roots, stem, leaves, etc. And there, in non-flowering, non-flowering plants may not have roots, stem, leaves, etc. The example of algae you can take, where you will know that the body is made up of single cell. So such parts are not seen there. This is the second point. Now here, for the difference, writing only 2 points is enough because the question is going to appear for 2 marks. Now if space is there, you can write down remaining 2 points. Okay, the third point here is flowering plant bear fruits with seeds, because since flowers are there, afterwards they are converted to fruits, and fruits they have seeds inside. So you can write this point here, that flowering plants bear fruits with seeds. Non-flowering plants do not bear fruits with seeds. And one more point, space is less, I am only telling you. So you can write in your rough book also, if you really want the point to be written. Last one, flowering plants are more evolved. Non-flowering plants are not much evolved. Why they are evolved? Because they have all the parts like roots, stem, leaves, etc. So they are called as evolved. And opposite to that, non-flowering may not bear the parts like roots, stem, leaves, etc. So they are not much evolved. Okay. So this is the difference. Keep habit of writing here in the lecture itself so that your work will not be piled up. Please take a note of this. Next one. A tree and a shrub. We have discussed so many times about a tree and a shrub. So I think writing the points is very easier for you. On the basis of the height itself, you can say that a tree grows tall. First point, a tree grows tall. Opposite to that, in the shrub, the first point is a shrub does not grow tall. So write down the first point. Once again, I am dictating. A tree grows tall. And in shrub, a shrub does not grow tall. Okay. The second point, you can see on page number 20 and 21, information about trees and shrubs is given. So if you have any doubt there or in some problem with spellings, you can see in textbook also it is appearing on screen. So your choice. You can see second one, a tree is large in size. A tree is large in size. And in shrubs, a shrub is small in size. You know that tree is having very thick trunk. Okay? Very thick and hard trunk it is having. Also, it is having a canopy, that is shady structure is there because of many branches above the ground. Opposite to that, shrub is not having that big canopy and branches you can see at some very close to the ground, not at some height but very close to the ground. So because of this, trees are large in size and shrub is small in size. Okay, so second point. Third one, trees are perennial. Okay, opposite to that, shrubs, they are annuals or biennials, you can say. Sometimes they live for many years also. So if you have space, write this point. Otherwise, don't write this point. One more point is there, that trees give out branch at some height. And shrubs, they give out branches very close to the ground. As I have discussed in second point, that why trees, they appear large in size. And shrubs, they appear small in size. Okay. Writing 2 points is enough. You can write down the first 2 points. The space is less in the workbook, so don't try to write down extra there. Writing 2 points is enough. Let us go further. Third one, that is vertebrates and invertebrates. You know vertebrates means what? The animals which are having vertebral column. And invertebrates means animals which do not have vertebral column. So the very first point you can write that. Write down the first point. Vertebrates have a vertebral column in their body. Vertebrates have a vertebral column in their body. And there in invertebrates, you will only add the word do not. Invertebrates do not have a vertebral column in their body. You know what is meaning of vertebral column? I told you in the lecture that touch the center of your back and you will find the chain of bones there. That chain of bones is called as vertebral column. Okay, so first point is completed. Go to the second point. Vertebrates have well-formed organs. Vertebrates have well-formed organs. And only add the word do not. Invertebrates do not have well-formed organs. Okay. Examples you can write as a third point. And third point is, vertebrates are evolved animals. Why evolved animals? Second point is same actually. Because they have well-formed organs. So they are called as what? Evolved animals. Opposite to that, invertebrates do not have well-formed organs. So they are called as primitive animals. They are not much evolved. So they are called as primitive animals. Examples in vertebrates are fish, snake, birds, frog, man. All these animals, they have vertebral column. And invertebrates, amoeba, snail, insects, earthworm. All these animals do not have vertebral column. Okay. So today we are stopping here. We have discussed 6 questions, and all of you please keep habit of completing workbook on time. After completion of these question answers, I am going to start with activity. Okay. So I will tell you that time you will be ready with your activity book so that we can complete those activities. Okay, students. So stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Okay, bye and thank you.